poetry and mental health is a natural intersection. As a clinician, I think I often use writing poetry as an intervention. One thing that poetry does really well, it expands narratives, it's able to tell stories that are often not heard, and sometimes the stories that people consider on the fringes. Then one of the most important things too is about the reframing of one's story. So in poetry, we have prompts and exercises and all these ways to enter into a poem and to tell your story. Same thing with mental health. We're asking people to consider something different. We think about cognitive therapy and we think about how can we rethink or reframe these situations and circumstances that are happening to us. The Healing Verse Poetry Project, particularly the Healing Verse Poetry line, it's really a natural extension of those two parts of me where I wanted to offer our community a telephone line where you can pick it up and call and hear a 90-second poem that's about healing and affirming. So poetry has these beautiful moments, but also poetry offers you space for reflection. I love that poetry can be loud and proud and be totally obnoxious in the street if it needs to be. And I also love that it can be soothing and calming and beautiful. It can put the baby to sleep. It can keep you at the block party going. But it can also, you can read it to your grandmother. You can do whatever you need to do with poetry. It's magical. That's the kick I get out of being a teaching artist and a poet, because every community that I've gone into and been able to say, your voice is poetry, your experiences and your stories have value. And when I've been able to do that, and at the end of my 40-minute, workshop with folks, and they come out and they're so proud and they're reading and, they hog the mic and all this other stuff, they say, I'm a poet. And that's a proud badge. That's a proud label to wear. In this season, we have learned the winter of this place. We know its grip, its claw, its hold. We claim this land and all its fickle streets. We feel its pull, its stark, its cold. But still we porch sit, basketball and barbecue. We labor, we grind, we languish and grieve. We paint and poem, we wither and bloom. We name ourselves, our blocks, our hood. We make this place rich, we call it home. We know barren, loss and vibrancy, gatherings, leavings, and harvest in our city. In this place that has birthed and buried, that has wounded and restored, that has chaos and stain running through its cobblestones and concrete, here in our magical spaces, on our sacred streets, neighbors and decent people dwell and offer us an embrace, a new day, light, ease, release, offers us a season for healing. And in this season of naming and of holding space for the quieted and the muted to be amplified, in this season of shifting, of barrier breaking, undoing, unearthing, uprising, leveling, you, beloved, may think yourself too small, may think your intentions and acts too slight, may think you are but a fragment, a mere atom in this place of stars and gazers. But what a world you are. What a spare of shocking beauty and grace. Do you not see how your one song, your one breath, one step, your one voice, your one pause, one lift, one shout, one protest brought us here, keeps us here? You say that it's only a speck you offer, just a tiny bit, a smidge, a morsel. But do you not see the feast ahead it prepares? How even the remains have purpose, how it beckons all to your grand table, how it feeds us and fills us and expands. Friend, you are a balm in these prickly times. You are a vessel, a refuge, of respite.